Welcome back, fellow coders. My name is Fernando here at Codamon, and today we're going to keep working on our CLI application. So today I plan on, let's add a new feature here for our AL argument. That's going to be the file stats, things like file permissions, who's the owner, size, etc. And you will normally see that so we have file permissions, the owner, size and bytes. We have date information, time, and then the file name. So we want to be able to see that. And so I think on this video, we're going to work on this. And if we have enough time, we'll try to implement the columns, although the columns seems like might be a little bit of difficult thing to implement, at least from the perspective that I have. But we'll worry about that after we're done with the stats. Okay, so let's do a quick Google search. And if we go to the Python documentation, we're actually using let's check our version here. Believe it's 3.7.5. So let's make sure that we're on the right documentation. It shouldn't change that much, but you never know. So this actually comes from the OS module that we've talked about before, and I believe this is everything that we need here. See if we can find a quick tutorial. Okay, so let's let's go ahead and think about how we'll implement that. So that would have to be done here, where we're listing files. So instead of printing out the files, we need to print with all the stats. The problem with this, I don't know if we need to get the full path. Maybe. So we can do another function. Maybe up here. Is there a directory? Let's actually do something to see what we get for now. So let's believe there's a current working directory. Okay, so if so that's how we get the current working directory. And that's what we will want here. So we'll just call this current working directory. And then I'm just going to print the stats of the file, so it will be print. What's the current working directory? Okay, so that's gonna should print a tuple with all those 10 things that are shown here. Just want to see how it looks before we start working with that data. So here we're gonna comment this out. And we'll call okay, let's see what we get. LSPy LS. Yeah, let me close this. Okay, so it looks like everything's working. We're getting our tuple. I wanted to figure out what we actually want from there on the this estimate is this. We'll just have to convert that. One of the things I actually like, I don't know, I haven't been a long time Linux user like some people, but when I first started learning about chmod permissions, I always thought the numbers make more sense to me, like 777, you know, 7 whatever, instead of this thing right here. I don't know, maybe that's just me, but this is understandable as well. The owner, I'm not sure if the owner is part of that. It might be this UID. Let's see the documentation. Yeah, user ID of owner. And then group ID. So what we can do here is add one thing at a time. So we'll start from this, and I think we can just append the file to the end, and then we'll start working our way and add everything. So we don't need to print this yet. We'll just call it stats. And let's see. Now, Okay, let's just see, do numeric names, numeric value for now. Chopping. I'm not sure if that's going to work, but we'll give it a try. Did work. And I'm just doing numeric value for now, but offline, once I work on this on my repository, I'll make it just like the original one. I just think doing this right now, might take a little long to format everything correctly. Okay, so now that we have that that we can work on, I actually don't know what this is. Have links to this? No. Okay, so let's see. This is going to show the same thing. I actually never paid attention. There was a letter there before. Long listing format. Okay, I think we're getting somewhere. Okay, so I already need this. These are the groups and the owner. And this is, if it's a D, it's a directory. If it's a L, it's a link. But what is this fifth field? This field specifies the number of links or directories inside the directory. Okay. And what did we get? Did I clear it? Okay, so it's just one. Okay, I understand now. We'll just leave this up. Just we need a reference again. That number of links. I wonder if that's in the stats. Okay, that's gonna be our third. Okay, that's going to be the third place in the tuple. So and stats, did I say three? Go ahead and add how many spaces are. Okay, I'll just add one, and then number of links. Let's go ahead and add the. The file. Just so. Get a little clearer sense. What's going on? Okay, LSPy. L. There we go. I think the spaces that are needed when you add a when you concatenate with commas. Let's see. That looks better. Okay, so what's let's go back to our field six. So user and group. Which is this next two. The only thing is that it's an ID, it's not a name. So Okay, well, it looks like this has been answered here, so let's try that. Let's go ahead and import. And let's go ahead and add. We don't actually need Yeah, we don't need the stats because we already have the stats here. So let's see what that does. And that one is called. We'll just call it user. Well, yeah, we'll just call it user. Find owner. Let's see what we get with that. Number of links, so we'll add it here. Okay, that worked beautifully. Code them on. Root. Okay, seems like things are moving along just great. And then we're gonna try to get the group, which is almost identical to this one. And it's gonna be 5. And then we'll add the group here. So this function doesn't work for groups. Okay, so we need to know. Okay, so there's another function for that, which is this one right here. We need to import it. So find group. Still call UID GID. And we don't need this. so it should be working now. Okay. Now there's one thing here that I don't like that we'll have to fix is, you know, it's the root. But those things are cosmetic and should be able to fix them. Maybe later on if we don't have enough time today. So if we run the next thing is size. Is it the next one? Yeah. Wrong brackets. Okay, awesome. We have the size now. Let's see what this. I know it's a date, but is that the field 9? The date of last modification, which is one after size. Number 8, I believe that's gonna be, it's not gonna be a standard date format. So we'll have to figure out how to convert it. Everything you've ever wanted to know is in Stack Overflow or somewhere on the internet. Someone at some point in their life, they have already figured out what you're looking for. Okay, well, let's go ahead and try this one. All you can do is try. If you get an exception, if you get an error, then you know, just keep trying to figure it out. So we'll import daytime and let's copy this, but it's not going to be what we need. So let me paste it here and actually don't need this. I guess we can call it mod timestamp. I don't know. Let's go ahead and delete these. Okay. It's looking good. Here on the left side is our application. With some very minor modifications. And we still have to, we have the numeric permissions, which some people probably don't like. So I'll have to figure out how to format this in the standard format, and then I had to figure out how to get these columns. But all of that stuff is kind of boring stuff, right? So the next thing that we can work on, actually, I'm trying to figure out if we can figure out the columns. Oh, what the hell? Let's do it. By the way, when you find things like this, what I usually do is, I'm not logged in as this is a virtual box, but I usually just upload if I find a good answer and save them my favorites, and I have tons of favorites. Another good thing that you can also do is save that link in your code, somewhere in your code where you can kind of reference it. We'll just reference here, because that was pretty useful. We actually found the group, the user and the group in the same one answer. This was pretty useful as well. This was just beautiful. I mean, it has a whole explanation on every single stat. Okay, how to print. just running. Okay, let's go ahead and just try something and see what we get. So what we can do here is print. And then format. Then our objects are going to be there, our strings. So first one's going to be numeric. And all of those are going to be the same number of digits. So we'll just have one space. Number of links is going to be the same. We can actually just copy this whole thing. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. The number of links, let's say we want some padding here. On user, which is 1, 2, 3. Let's just see what that does. does this one? Okay, so we get some padding here. Think that might be too much though. Looks like what happens if we do this. Don't understand the full formatting pattern. Okay, so padding. I just add padding everywhere, see what happens. I'm actually going to leave this up here and just make this a little bit bigger. So on this one, let's go ahead and add 10. Yeah, let's just pad everything. I'm sure there's better ways. Size. Just want some kind of that actually might be too much. It's looking better. Actually, what happened to I think the date? Did the day get cut off? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I'm sure what happened. Let's remove this. I don't know what happened there. But as you can see, we're getting pretty close to having a full, almost full LS utility. We don't have that many lines of code. We're almost up to an hour now. Every time I make a video, I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna do a quick feature and make a quick video, and then end up being long anyways. So I hope that in this video you learned about how to get file stats, how to work with them. In the next video, we should definitely, we're most likely gonna look at how to do the columns and the LS without any arguments. It's by far, I think, the hardest problem about this utility, and probably why I left it last. I think the colors, I'm just gonna do those offline. That should be pretty easy for anyone to do. But the columns, we'll tackle that on the next video. And hopefully it'll be our last video, and then we can compare our utility with the LS Unix utility that's been around for a long time, probably twice as my age. So I'll be committing this to my GitHub. Feel free to check out the code there. If you have any comments or anything, just let me know on YouTube or on the repository. I hope you enjoyed the video, and thank you for watching. Until the next one.